Hi crocheters of the world, this is the tunic, asymmetrical tunic that we will work together in this tutorial. You also have the written instructions on my blog. Actually, in the tutorial I just pass you through the most difficult steps and in working this pattern that I designed with the broomstick lace without the broomstick. So I'll add you to the tutorial. Happy crocheting! So in the tutorial I will work actually with a little bit thicker yarn and with 4mm hook, and I have here 51 plus 1 chains, but you just go on and choose your measure from my blog, okay, and follow the instructions here. So actually I will walk you through all the important steps, so how to increase, how to develop the yoke and so on. Now for the very first row we will just single crochet in each chain across, and from the second we will begin with our rows that when we work the broomstick lace without the lace, without without the broomstick, we have 2 steps to complete to work 1 entire row, and you'll see what am I talking about. Okay, so once you finish the single crochet you will begin by dividing in different parts of front side, sleeve, back side, sleeve and front side, and in between them we will put the 4 raglan increases. So for the front side, so I chained 1, I insert hook into the first single crochet, slip stitch, and for the front side I will work 3 loops into the very first single crochet, then into the second I will work 6 loops together, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Why? Because this is the first raglan increase. Now I will continue on with 9 on the next 9 single crochets, because this will be the sleeve. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, and these are for the sleeve. And now into the very next, in between the sleeve and the back side, I will work the other increase, raglan increase. So into the next single crochet I will work again 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and now I will continue on with my 27 stitches for the back side. 3, 4, 26 and 27. So I have my back ready. Now into the very next single crochet again 6 for the third raglan increase. 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now I will work again the sleeve, so 9 stitches for the sleeve, and then into the last 2, second to last, I will work 6 again for the last raglan increase, and into the last single crochet I will work as I worked at the beginning, 3 for the first group of 3 of the front side. I worked my 9 for the sleeve, now into the second to last. I'm working on my last raglan increase, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And into the last, as we began, we finish with 3, 1, 2, and 3. Now let us begin, well, we finished the first step of the row. Let us begin the second step. And when we finish the second step, I promise you, you will understand all that we work here. Now it's a little bit confused, and I know. Now, we will work groups of 3 together. So this is 1, 2, 3. The 3 that we work into the last. Yarn over, pull through all, chain 1, and work 3 single crochets. 2 and 3. Now here we have the 6 for the raglan increase. We work 3 together. 1, 2, 3. Of course with 3 single crochets. Chain 2 and work 3 more together. And these 3 are for the... Okay, now we just worked 1 raglan increase. We go on the sleeve, and on the sleeve, if you remember, we have 9, which means we'll be 3 groups of 3 together. So, 1, 2, 3, this is the first. We always work 3 single crochets, 2, 3, over 3. The next, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. This is the last for the sleeve. 1, 2, and 3. And here we are with the second raglan increase. We work the same thing. 1, 2, 3 over the first 3 rings. Then chain 2. You can also chain 3 if you want to. And 3 more together. 1, 2, 3. Doesn't matter if you put the marker or not, because the corners are really, really nice and you can see them. Okay, now on my 27 rings that I worked, or loops, sorry, that I worked for the backside, I will work 3, 3, 3 together, so I will have 9 groups. On my 9, I have 3. Okay, so I will work my 9 groups on my 27 loops, and then I will be back to show you how to finish. So work 3 together, 3, 3, 3. Single crochets, 1, 2, 3. Again, 3 together and 3 single crochets. This is the most important and, let's say, the most difficult round to understand. From here, it's really clear. So I finished. This is my 3rd raglan increase. It's really obvious where it is. Now I have 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, this is my backside. Let us work our 3rd raglan increase. So we work over 3 single crochets, chain 2, and over the next 3. 1, 2, and 3. And now I will continue on repeating what I worked here. So 3 groups of 3 for the sleeve, then the last raglan increase, and over the last 3 work 3 single crochets. And this is the very first row, actually, of the pattern, and this is the most important, actually, row. So when you work it in pattern, in your size, just work it carefully. This row, work it carefully, and we'll be okay then. And this is what we have. Now this is really really clear. Now it's really really clear because we have the chain two, which are the corners of the increases, and now we also increase here, so instead of three we have five groups. From now on we will talk about these groups, okay? So one broomstick lace, how do you want to name it? I name it a sequence of three. So these are the sequence. This is what am I talking about in the written instruction, okay? So from corner to corner, here we have 11. 9 plus these two that we put it with the increase. Now from here, we will continue on for the entire yoke, increasing on the raglan increase, exactly the same. So into the chain two we work six, and then into the second step with the single crochet we divide them as we divide them here. So three together, chain two, three together. For this part, so for the front a neck line on front side, we will increase into each of our second row until the front side with the back side will have the same number of groups of three. How we will increase? Very easy. Now in this one I don't want to increase, so what I want to do is just to work the stitches as they are. One, two, so I have two groups now for the front side, so six loops there will be. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, into the chain two, as I said, we work 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and we will continue on like this, working 3, 3, 3, 3, and into the chain two, 6, and so on exactly until the end. I will finish this row and I will be back just to show you how to increase at the beginning and at the end of the row. Okay, I finished my second row, and now as I said, in each of my odd number row, or it's 1, 3, 5 and so on, I will increase on the front into the first and the last stitch. So I will add actually one more group on one side and on the other side, group of three. Okay, and for these I will work like this, chain and work with 4.5, and insert hook into the single crochet and work the first. Now work one more, all into the same single crochet, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, so three are for the group that we already, that we just added, and the one is for the 1, 2, 3, this group that we have. Okay, and we continue on like this. The rest is exactly the same as I showed you. Okay, now in each of our odd number row, for the front side we will add not only one group of three with the raglan increase that we add with the raglan increase, but two, because we added, actually we add one at the beginning too. So we worked two together and then three, because we worked only the raglan increase. Into this third row we will add five groups of three, okay, because we work the raglan increase and we added one here. Now at the end of this increase round, at the beginning and at the end, at the end we work into the last single crochet four loops, exactly as we worked at the beginning. So we will continue on like this until the sum of the groups of the front side, left and right, it's left and right, sorry, will be exactly the same as the number of groups that we have on the back side. So now we will have 5 here, 5 here, which means 10, and here we will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 11, 12, 13, plus 2, because we will increase, will be 15. So 10 and 15, and we will continue on until we have the same number of groups. So here I am, I finished with the part of the increases for the neckline, and now I have to join. I made a mistake. I said you have to increase for the neckline shape in each of your odd numbers row, or in each of your second row, and this is not true. You will have to increase in each row until the front side, both sides, are almost the same of the back. Why almost? And this is all written on the written instructions, so don't worry. Why I said almost? Because on the front side we began with 2, then we increased by 2 in each row, so 4, then 6, and into this one we have 8, plus 8, because we are two sides, is 16. And on the back side we began with 9, 11, 13, so we have an odd number. So now we have 17, and on the front side 16, so it's this one sequence, you know a sequence, it's this one sequence less we'll have on the front side for now, but I will show you how to put it, so how to add it. Okay, so now I will join, because it's a pullover, it's a tunic, so here we want to join, and we will continue of course with the yoke. Okay, now to join, simply slip stitch and cut the yarn. I don't have scissors here. So let's see where we will begin. This is what we have. I cut the yarn, and I want now to insert hook on the left, in between the left side front and left sleeve, the raglan increase here. So it's here into the chain 2 that I will insert my hook and join the yarn again. Now, here usually we work 6 loops into the chain 2 space, but now we will only work 3. 1, 2 and 3. And now I will just continue on working all around, of course continuing increase, because we haven't finished yet with the yoke, so we just continue on working the 4 raglan increases, so 6 loops, and then each 3 loops together, chain 2, 3 loops together into the second step of the row. So just let me go on around, and I will be back to show you how to increase here, so how to put, to add 3 more loops, so we will have exactly the same number of sequences on the front as for the back side. Okay, so I'm working here on my last sequence before the slip stitch, where I slip stitched to join the 2 front sides, and here I am. This is the slip stitch, this is the last before the slip stitch, and this is the first sequence of the left side. Now, how we will add 3 more loops. So into the same single crochet where I finished to work my last sequence of the right side, I will put one more loop into the slip stitch. Actually a little bit difficult because it is tight, but we can do it. One loop and we have two. And now into the first single crochet of the first sequence of the left side, I will work one, and now I have three for my new sequence, and one more, which is the one of the first sequence of the left side. Okay, and then I am just continuing working my first step of the row, and I want to show you how to finish of the round. Sorry, because this is the first round. I just want to show you how to finish the round and how to begin another round. These are things that I didn't explain in the written instructions. So these are things that are easier to explain on a video. Okay, so I am at the end. I'm working on my last sequence. And here I am. Now I know that I have to complete with three more loops here and on the chain two space, of course. And this is exactly what I will do. One, two, and three. And now I can say I finished my first round. To begin another one, I will just turn my work and insert hook through the first three, or the last three loops actually that we worked, and work three single crochets and continue on exactly the same. I will be back to show you how to finish and to begin, actually to finish the round, because we will work the chain two space in a different way. Okay. Now I will just continue on working the stitches as they are. Don't forget to work the chain two on your three raglan increases, and here I will be back, as I said, to show you how to finish and to begin another row. Here I am at the end of my round, and now let me show you how to finish. To finish, you will yarn over, insert hook into the first single crochet, pull up a loop, three loops on the hook, yarn over, pull through all three loops, chain one, and turn your work. Now we are again on the front, on the right side, and we begin to work our first step of the next round, which means pull up loops. We pull three loops on our chain two space, which in this case is the half double crochet. We go on all around, and we will end by pulling up three more loops, half double crochet, chain one, and then we will turn, three more loops, and then we will work as I showed you before with the single crochet. Okay, so we turn and single crochet all around. So this is how you have to continue on for the length until you will open actually the tunic. Okay, and yes, this is how you have to continue on. Now I will work one more round here, just to work one more round, and then I will show you the next important step, which is the division, of course, where we will work only the front and the back side, and we will leave out the sleeves. And now to divide the two, so the front, back from the sleeves, and to work only the body, we will work another single crochet round. So we finish the yoke with a single crochet, of course, because we have these two steps to complete to finish a round. and we will work only a single crochet row around, sorry, more. And I'm here at the end, and I just want to chain two. So at the end of your last single crochet row round, don't half double crochet, but chain two, insert hook into the single crochet and slip stitch to join. And on the wrong side, so I am on the wrong side now, go on and work the front side. One single crochet into each of your single crochet of the previous round, and then I will be back to show you what to do when you are on the chain two space, so on the actually raglan increase between the front side and the sleeve. Okay, so I leave the chain two for the sleeve here, okay, and to skip on the back side, I will chain three. But as I said, in the written instruction, you have it, for larger sizes, you will chain six, okay? So chain three and skip exactly into the first single crochet of the back side. Okay, and that's it. We just continue on working the back side, and then here we will work exactly the same thing. Slip stitch into the front side, and then we will begin with the round of the loops and so on. So I finished, I chained three and slip stitch into the first single crochet. Now I divide it all, and we will go on and work in length for the until the, let's say, the waistline, a little bit up. And what I want to, there is just one more thing I have to show you actually in the tutorial. The rest of the pattern, you have it written on my blog, so you will follow that one. I just want to show you one more thing, how to divide actually when you will work the front side. So as you saw, it's divided, and we will work the front side and the back side separately. And I want to show you how to do this exactly with this chain three, with this sequence that we put here, okay? Now, how to begin the new round after the division is really easy. So we divide, we finish like this, we turn our work, so we are again on the front, on the right side. So only always work on the right side the loops, okay, and on the wrong side the single crochets, and insert hook into the first chain of the chain three that you just worked, slip stitch into the first and begin with the first loop, then into the second, work the second loop, and so on, the second loop and the third. And from here it's pretty clear how you will continue on to work. So for the single crochet work, turn and work, okay? So okay, now I just work this round, and then I will be back actually to show you how to divide, even if here it's not the moment to divide, but it's okay, just to show you this step too. Okay, so I finished. Let's say that it's here that I want to begin to work separately front and back, and I have this sequence in the middle. From this sequence, I cannot put it on front side and back side. I must have exactly the same number of sequences on front side and the back side. So from this one sequence, and this is for medium and large size, I think, larger sizes we will have two sequences here, so this is not a problem. We will work one for the front side and one for the back side here and on the other underarm. But here we have only one, and from this one we need two. So we will create two and I show you how. I am here, I will turn and I will slip stitch on this sequence one and two single crochets. So until the single crochet in the middle, we have three into the second one. And from here, I will begin like this. I will work one here and into the next, I will work two, which means I put a new sequence on the front side, okay? Then I will work my sequences on the front and then here, I will work exactly the same thing. Two loops into this one and one loop into this one. And then I will go and work in rows. When I begin the back side, I will work exactly the same thing. So here, I will begin into the same single crochet where I put my, this one, this loop. So into the second single crochet of the underarm sequence. I will begin here with one loop and then I will work two loops here to put another sequence and the same thing, of course, underarm on the other sleeve. Okay, this is the explanation for this step of the pattern. What I want more, just one more thing I want to explain to you, and this is the how to work the sleeve and actually how to decrease, okay? It's not difficult, but maybe it's better for you to see it than to read it from the written instructions. So, and now the sleeve. I want to show you how to decrease, but first of all, I want to show you how to begin to work in round the sleeve. Now, I have here my chain three, where I added my sequence. Into the first of it, I will insert my hook. And if you have six, so for larger sizes, if you have six, then you begin with that. Or you can begin with three, so in the middle three, and then you will finish with the other three. And I will work three loops here. Then the chain two, you know that we left it here for the sleeve. And we will work in each on one side and on the other side, we will work in each three loops. So actually we will add two sequences more. Okay, let me finish this first round and I will be back to show you the decrease. Now, of course, so I finished, now I turned my work, so turn your work and begin with the second step with the single crochet. Now, of course, you will have to complete some rounds normally and then you will begin with the decreases, but this is written in the pattern. Now, I just want to show you. Into the second step of the round, we begin with the decrease. We will always decrease just one sequence at the time and will be a decreased work in I don't know, three or four rows, rounds, you will see, I don't remember now. So for the first step, let's say, of the decrease, we will decrease like this. First decrease will be the first three, the first sequence, first three loops. The other decrease will be the last. Then again, the first and the last on the round, I said, okay? Now, instead of working three single crochet, we will work only two. And the rest, we just continue on working our working our single crochets here, three single crochets, working three loops, okay, so normally. At the end of this round, I insert hook into the last of the first of the two single crochets here, chain, and now I turn and I will begin with three loops, and here on my two loops, I will actually work only two loops on my two single crochets, sorry, so at the end this time because I turned, okay? So just pull up loops as you normally work for the broomstick lace, like this. And at the end, don't forget to pull up only two loops. And this is the second step, let's say, of the decrease, yes. So I finished my round and now I will begin another one, so the third step on my decrease, and I turn. So as you can see, I always turn after I finish, so to begin a new round. So now I will work as I turn. I have again first on the first here on the so the first sequence, my sequence to decrease. So I will insert hook only in the two loops, okay, of the two single crochets, and I will work only one single crochet, and this is the third step in decreasing one sequence, and then I just continue on with three single crochet in each of my three loops worked together. So I finished this round too. I want to insert hook into this single crochet and slip stitch to join, turn, don't forget to turn. And now I will begin again with this, with the sequence, so the normal sequence. And here I will finish with my single crochet, solitary single crochet of the sequence that I am decreasing, I can say, because it's a long process. So I will work one loop in this lonely single crochet, and into the next single crochet step or row or round, we will finally eliminate it. I finished this step two, and now finally we will just decrease in the proper way. So we have this solitary loop here of our sequence to decrease, and we take it on our hook, and we take on our hook the first sequence, so three more loops. Okay, don't forget, this is the most important step to decrease, actually. So the fifth step, the last. So we have four loops on the hook, okay? And we will work only three single crochets. So this means from the next round, we won't have it anymore. And this is how we will go on to decrease sequence by sequence in five different steps. So we work these five steps, we decrease one sequence, then we work a round, completely round, with the step of the loops and the single crochet. And then we begin another five steps to decrease another sequence. And we continue on like this until we have the circumference that we want for the wrist, okay? That's it, that's all. As you can see, it's not that difficult. The important thing is you to understand how to work the stitch, how to increase and decrease with it, but I think it's all clear. Watch and read the written instruction carefully, and you'll see you will be able to work a nice tunic. You can work it in cotton for summer or springtime, or as you really wish. Hope you enjoy this tutorial and this mind design. Thank you so much for following me in this crochet adventure. Don't forget to subscribe and to like my tutorials, of course, if you like them. And follow me on Facebook. Send me some nice photos on my Facebook page with your projects worked inspired by my tutorials. See you at the next tutorial. Bye-bye.